So we'll be meeting in the next city meeting or?
Well, our plan is that we'll, Scott is working with, he explained what we're going through to get that scheduled. So, with that being said, we can jump right into that. Sorry.
At your last meeting, you discussed the desire to meet with the Valdosta City Council to share with them face to face, elect official your concerns, and how we might be able to assist them going forward to accelerate their capital improvements to correct the situation to hopefully eliminate this in a much shorter timeframe. The Valdosta City Council has a very structured meeting format. Spoken with the city clerk, the city manager, and made a request to them to have a regular agenda item or attend the meeting. Present the resolution from the county and cities that they're adopting later this month, and discuss this matter. And was told both by the city clerk and the city manager that the opportunity to do that is during the 3-minute citizen comment period. So I said, well, so there's no opportunity to have a regular agenda item or to be more thorough and robust discussion about this item. So that is not an option. And suggested that you meet individually with the mayor, the chief elected official who represents the city council. I said, well, we already met with you as city manager, your utilities director, your public information officer, and the mayor. I'm very appreciative of that and relay those concerns to them. But task force I work for, elected officials, counties want to meet with your elected officials and discuss this matter directly eyeball to eyeball. So I said, well, what about scheduling a workshop just to deal with this subject matter? And he said they don't have single purpose workshops. What they do is they meet twice a month. Prior to their first meeting is the month meeting when they handle their planning and zoning items. They have a workshop a few days before that meeting to discuss items that will be coming up on the meeting later that week. However, those subject matters are limited to 15 minutes each. And then circle back to, I think you'll do better meeting with the mayor. So we'll get back to talk to my chair and the task force meeting later today and see how much they can approach that.
We can do that.
I see 30 minutes.
Right.
So I'm in here for
next
That's certainly an option. Another option the chair and I have discussed is for him and the vice chair to attend their meeting on the 21st this month, appear during the 3-minute citizen comment period, present the resolutions, briefly discuss the topic, and request the city council to schedule a workshop to meet with this task force and the city council to discuss this matter on a more thorough basis.
One more time, Scott. Who did you talk to?
The city clerk and the city manager. Well, that's also interesting. They meet the first Thursday following the first Sunday, and then 2 weeks following that Thursday. So half the months during the year appears they meet the second and fourth Thursdays, and the other months during the year they end up meeting the first and third Thursdays. So January is the second and fourth. February, March would be the first and third Thursdays.
February, March, and the night?
Yes, the five.
And when do they do public comment?
At the end of the meeting.
Yeah, I like your idea.
Yeah, I'm sure we can get some other guests to go if they really want to honestly play a game like that. I mean, that's ridiculous. I mean, that's poor.
I'd say I was somewhat
disrespectful.
I was somewhat surprised by the response I got to your request, the structure protocol of the meetings.
Yes, sir.
Is it generally called citizen comment or is it public comment? Because are they going to jerk the rug out from underneath of us and say,
right,
you're not a citizen of the state of Georgia or the city of Valdosta?
Thank you.
We've had some representation of folks that Florida residents attended the city of Valdosta meetings in the past.
Yeah.
How was that addressed?
Yeah, so in lieu of me attending this last meeting that you all had, I drove up there. It was public comment. They did engage with me. So after I spoke, there was a certain amount of back and forth exchange. So it was very strict to 3 minutes. Like, that was it. But then the conversation from, I think, all of the board members and John was there too. And they might have even offered some public comment toward the end of the meeting. How'd that go? I mean, there was an exchange.
They did. They will let anyone speak. If you want to see how that went, it's all on video. I'll point you at where it is. Also, the district meeting that he's referring to is all on video. You can see it. They will let anyone speak. They may or may not respond. You do have sympathetic ears on the city council, not necessarily at the very highest levels, but on the city council. And if you get enough city council members saying they want an agenda item, there will be an agenda item.
Well, that was one of my questions to Scott earlier on the phone today when we were discussing this. I said, well, I mean, is it like in Florida, of course, any commissioner or whatever can have an item placed on the agenda for discussion. And I was wondering if that was pretty much the way Georgia worked. But
I don't know how many of them it will take, but if you get enough city council members wanting an agenda item, there will be one.
And if you watch that video, you can see who responds to public comment, a citizen, and those would be the people, of course, to... Yeah.
I'm just wondering if you wouldn't make more progress with those people, if two or three people went instead of a whole bunch of us going and act like we were trying to push ourselves on them or bully them.
One of the conversations that we had is we present or discuss this issue with them and specifically request a scheduled workshop with their council and this board and this body, set up another date so we can sit down and have specific item discussion about ways that we can collectively and jointly resolve the issue. And I don't want to put anything out there, but I'm just saying for your suggestion, do you think that in Senator Rubio's office or Scott's office that they may help spearhead some of these meetings?
You know, we would be more than happy. We'd have to talk to our folks in D.C. who handle these policy issues, but we can absolutely do that tomorrow and get back with you.
I'm wondering, this may be very, very simple here, but when you go to Mount Oscar, what's the ask? What's the ask? You can ask them to stop, you can ask them for a time frame, you can ask them, what's the ask? Because I think you're obliged to do that, as you would with anything, to try to resolve this too. But it strikes me that there are other entities that need to weigh in on this, and that would be through the Water Management District, as you have done, and through DEP. DEP has a counterpart in Georgia. I mean, they need to have this on their tip of their agenda, and we need to know, have they, NOAA, who are his designated. I don't want to undermine anything here, Greg, because I know you've done a lot of work here.
And part of this discussion, Rick, is the fact that we have reached out to Georgia's Environmental Protection Department. We have reached out to this other state and federal regulatory agencies. And we have had some progress, but nobody seems to be able to.
What's the plan?
Jump on. No food plan.
Well, so you would obviously proceed until you're satisfied that there is a logical, understandable plan. And I think if, and I'm not placing this on NOAA or anybody else, but if they're in the position to track this for you guys, then they need to push it. I mean, obviously, you guys are sitting here meeting, 8 counties. And then, you heard me down in November. I mean, back in the day in the 60s, I was in college, and I'd be driving a septic tank truck up to Valdosta full of septic stuff and asking them where they want to deliver it. But obviously, that's not going to happen. I don't think, but it might get some attention. At the same time, you try to talk with them. What about the governor and cabinet?
Those are issues that Scott is working on getting the audience with.
All right.
and potentially with the AG, litigation. So, and all
those are kind of, Chris, those are kind of things or strategies that we've laid out in our first couple of meetings as far as who to contact, who we need to get on board, and join up with us.
Okay.
I think it makes a lot of sense for the chair and the vice chair to go during public comment to state that we requested a workshop, and the ask is for a workshop. And we can communicate that we've got 11 counties, or not 12 counties, and their representatives that are willing to drive up to the workshop. They were also willing to come up to public comment, but we didn't want to overtake public comment, so in respect to their time, you know, you are there representing this task force and looking for solutions. And so I think the ask is a workshop. Give them an opportunity to understand the gravity of what we're trying to do in Florida, and as great data for it to
And Mr. Chairman, and more importantly, what can we do to help expedite this process for you? You know, we're willing to reach out to the feds, we're willing to reach out to you, whatever other authorities may have money available to help this project move along faster rather than over their 10-year timeline that they laid out. Quite frankly, it's not acceptable.
Well, funding is going to be a major, major issue for the city, not us, as far as overcoming all the problems. And I know that we can help through our federal representatives. And to be able to assist them with their funding issues.